carbon dioxide there too. There's water vapor in the air on Mars, and sometimes it condenses into clouds. But the most impressive evidence for water on Mars is geological. Spacecraft images show huge channels on parts of the surface. Some of these appear to be carved by debris swept along by catastrophic floods. It would have taken volumes of water far larger than the Amazon to gouge channels like these through Martian bedrock. But perhaps the oddest thing about the Martian bedrock is what happened to it afterwards. The channels seem to be ancient.
From solar flares and cosmic rays. On Earth, this is deflected by a magnetic field. As a crew leaves on a 6-month flight to Mars, two severe solar flares that could have horrific long-term consequences for their health.
Solar flares occur unscheduled. And when a solar flare occurs on the surface of the sun, that emits energy.
Around 200.
NASA plans to send its most ambitious unmanned mission ever. Touching down where scientists suspect the ice is thinnest, the Europa lander will lower a probe. The surface of Mars is the same area as all the continents of Earth combined. There's an enormous choice of possible sites when it comes to collecting the priceless samples. Close-up pictures of the red planet have revealed tantalizing evidence that water once flowed across the surface of Mars.
We see clear geological evidence that there's been water on Mars. On some of the older surfaces, we see networks of valleys that look like river tributary systems, where waters flow through them, carved with long channels. The availability of water on the surface and the crust really, I think, is what makes it possible.